Good afternoon, everybody. This is Sangeeta Saxena, Editor, Aviation and Defense Universe, getting you live from Eurosatory. This is day two, and we are here at Tardit Technologies, which is an Indian company. And we have with us the CEO and the co-founder, Astha Varma. Welcome, Astha, to ADU's chat room. How does it feel to be here?
Very exciting, very nice. We are here for the first time, and it's a great place to see what the world is doing and what difference we are making to the world.
Very nice. And what is Tardit Technologies all about?
So Tardit is essentially an AI product company. Our core product is BrainBox, which is the AI platform indigenously built in India. It's very unique in the way it is the only AI platform which is a model-driven platform, and we rely on physics and not just data to do it. A very common misconception about artificial intelligence is that you need lots and lots of data. And that's exactly what we are trying to make here. We have made a platform which relies on physics and models rather than just the data. And this so happened because we started working in defense environment where you don't get connectivity, you don't have too much of data to play with, but the accuracy really needs to be high. And we had to rely on something which is unfailable, which is physics. And that's exactly what BrainBox brought into picture. Now, to get BrainBox to the world, we started making it into various different products. Today, what we are showcasing is an autonomous vessel, surveillance vessel, completely inbuilt in India, including the design of the boat, the instruments inside, that is various kind of sensor, and also the electric onboard motor, which has been made in India, which is completely AI torque optimized. What's very, very unique about this particular product is it has a homing feature, and this is not a remote operating vessel but completely autonomous. It can be launched from a mothership or it can be dropped from 50 feet high directly into the water to do a surveillance or a mission which it has been planned for.
Okay, very nice. And at the moment, what is the stage of development? What is the stage of sales? Have you already started talking to people? What is the general stage of business?
Stage of business, so to say, the product is almost ready. The trials are going on in Goa as we speak, and we do have very great inquiries from India and international navies across the world. Middle East has interest in from a couple of Middle East countries. We're talking to Saudi, Egypt, UAE itself, among other sectors. So the product has been accepted, it's been tried. The trials have been successful so far, both independently. So we tested the electric OBM separately, and we are testing the Meglan, that is the autonomous boat, separately, and they both are giving great results. Compared to a human, this is 85% accurate, which is about 8,500 times what a human can give you an accuracy about.
That's wonderful, absolutely. Technology takes over the human being, I think, at the end of the day.
Yes, but I like to say that it complements rather than taking it over, because we are not talking about, taking away from the person. What we are talking about, can I actually give you an assistance in a time of crisis? Because in a common scenario, a human mind can only take one decision in seven critical points. A machine can run through 1,000 critical scenarios at the same point of time. So in time of crisis, this is your place to go. This boat can do pirate detection. It can go ahead and detect dark vessel, that is the vessel which is not communicating. It can also detect if you are going the wrong way, because it's been designed to avoid collision. So there are multiple features which we have incorporated in a single boat. And what's great, that if somebody does not want the boat and just the AI bit of it, I can also do that. I can do a retrofit to an existing boat. It will not have autonomy, but it can give you actuation and it can give you an AI captain. Okay. So that both the worlds can enjoy the benefits.
Right, absolutely wonderful. And where are you based out of?
We are based in Bangalore, India.
Okay, and your facilities and workshops and labs and all that?
We are completely based in Bangalore. Completely. We are in Aerospace and Defense IT Park, which is specifically for this purpose.
Right.
Working out of one location. So
right. Now, you have a product here which is for the naval systems.
Correct.
What about products of the same nature for the aerospace and the land systems?
So, for aerospace, we are talking about an AI-based hangar. Now, a very common problem which we see, and specifically if I look into a defense environment, is when you have to park two planes in the same hangar. And that becomes quite critical, because presently it's been driven by humans. which means accuracy may not be that great. And that's where we are talking and discussing an AI-based hangar for that matter. If I look into the other part, we were talking about AI-based inspection for the halo blades and also about halo motors. So we have quite a different kind of products for the aerospace industry per se. Our specialty is on decision intelligence and structural fatigue, and that's what we take across industry. So we are something which takes on a dual use case product. So why you saw the defense application, the same thing as the commercial application. Why you saw it in marine, you can also take it to aerospace and underwater. So the region and the geography and the layer does not make a difference. As long as anywhere where decision intelligence is required, where the structural understanding needs to be done, we are there to help you out.
So you mean to say that shipping lines can also be your clients?
Absolutely. We are talking to merchant vessels. This is also being discussed by a few yacht manufacturers. Because the electric OBM, while the whole world is talking about going green, we do not know how to go about it. And we are talking about an electric outboard motor which can give you 20% better efficiency than what is available in the market today. And this is a definite step towards going green in this side.
Right. And all the parts which are coming into your systems, are they all indigenous or have you got some imported stuff in it?
So batteries for the OBMs is definitely not something which we make in-house. They are taken from wherever the suppliers are. We typically tell our international customers to source it locally. But in India, we have Indian manufacturers who make and provide us. But if you look at the boat, you look at the OBM, everything is made in India. The motor for the OBM, I have a partner in Germany. We co-manufacture it and bring it here. But rest, everything is made in India.
Right.
So I would like to highlight, we are 100% made in India company. I do not assemble. We made the tech, we made the product, and we made it in India.
Okay. And what is the plan at the moment, since you're still in the process of having a final product in your hand, what is the market which you envisage for it? Like, we are meeting at a show which is totally European, and you also have rest of the world. Well, how has it, have you got some feedback? Have you got interest from people in it? Have people come to see it?
Yes, a lot of interest has come in. In fact, we are discussing, one of my product is about the railways. So we are discussing, since we are in Europe, we are discussing with SBB as well, which is the Swiss Railways Network, to look into this particular product. We are looking at many European nations from Netherlands and other sites as well. We did have, as I said earlier, we have a lot of interest from the Middle East. Europe is a new market for me, and we are very, very open towards it, because in the marine side, Europe is the market to begin and deliver. And that's why we are here, to showcase our product in the marine segment, and we really look forward towards it.
Right, absolutely. And that was wonderful speaking with you, Astha. It's a new product, and so good to see a woman at the helm of affairs. It's always nice. Thank you so much. I'm sure that when we meet the next time, you'll have more to tell us about.